Hi, you are welcome to this series of rotational motion discussion. Here in this post, we would like to discuss if there is a body in rotational motion like this. Let us imagine a body who is in rotational motion like this. Let this is my axis of rotation where the body is revolving around that given axis. We want to understand why do we need angular displacement to study this motion. Why don't we study this rotational motion in terms of the displacement? We know displacement is the shortest distance between the initial and final positions. When a body with a distributed mass is in rotational motion, why can't we study it in the displacement itself? Why don't we study it? Why shall we need a new term like angular displacement? That's the point that I would like to consider. Let us consider a point P. Yes, let us consider a point. Let the point is moving in a given specified time T from P to Q because it is in rotational motion. Then what is the displacement of that point? We can draw a straight line as the shortest distance between the point P and Q. But if suppose, if you consider another point along the same line, this point if I consider, what is its displacement? Like this. Have you noticed that these two points are having different displacements? Let us consider another two points. They are having a different displacement. So, it is very clearly noticed that each particle of the body in a given time is having a different displacement. So, whose displacement we have to take to study the displacement of the entire body? You might have noticed that different particles of the same body in the same time t are having different displacements. This particle is having a displacement x, this particle is having a displacement y, this particle is having a displacement z. So who is the displacement of the body? Do we have to consider x to study the displacement of the entire body, where x, y, z are the displacements of the individual particles of the body, y or z? None of them actually represents the actual displacement of the body. In fact, this body motion cannot be studied with the displacement itself because different particles of the body are having different displacements. But if you notice the diagram, though different particles are having different displacements, at the origin, all of them are making the same angle. So, instead of studying the displacement of the body, we can consider the angular displacement. We can consider angular displacement. Angle, by how much it is displaced, is called angular displacement. The linear displacements are different for different points of the body, different particles of the body. But in a specified time, angular displacement is same for all the parts of the body. That's why while studying rotatory motion, we shall consider angular displacement instead of the displacement. We can write angular displacement is basically defined as angle. It's nothing but equal to arc by radius. Let this value of the arc equal to x. Let this radius is equal to r. Then I can write d theta is nothing but equal to x by r. Angular displacement is nothing but equal to x by r. You might have noticed that it is the ratio of the similar physical quantities, displacement by displacement. Therefore, it is not having any dimensional formula. It is not having any dimensional formula simply because it is the ratio of the similar physical quantities, not having any dimensional formula. It don't have any dimensional formula. because it is a ratio of similar physical quantities. But it has units. Angle is measured in a SI unit called radian. So this is one of the physical quantity which is not having a dimensional formula but having a unit of radian. If suppose the body completes one rotation, if one rotation about the given axis is completed, if one rotation is completed, angular displacement is generally shown with a letter d theta. The angle that it covers is nothing but equal to angular displacement is the 360 degree, or in terms of the SI system we can say its value is nothing but equal to 2 pi radian. Therefore, to study the rotational motion we cannot depend on displacement, because each particle is having different displacements for the same body. We can depend on angular displacement because all particles of the body are having the same angular displacement.